Hello everybody, today I am there with you with the same concept, that is volume of cylinder. We will solve some problems which are depend on the same concept. So first problem is the difference between outside and inside surface area of a cylindrical metallic pipe 14 cm long is 44 cm square. If the pipe is made of 99 cubic centimeters of metal, find the outer and inner radius of the pipe. Okay, we have to find out outer and inner radius of the pipe. Okay, so this is an example of hollow cylinder. Okay, so what is given once again, we will see the difference between outside and inside surface area. Okay, surface area means here we have to consider total surface area. Okay, so the difference of between total surface area of outside and inside cylinder is given 44 cm square. Okay, and what is given? Metallic pipe 14 cm long. Long is what here we have to consider, that is the height of the cylinder. Okay, so first, whatever given things are there, that we will mention. Okay, what is given? If the pipe is made of 99 cubic centimeters of metal, find the outer and inner radius of the pipe. Okay, so these two things we have to find out. So first, what we will do? Let the outer radius be capital R, generally we use capital R for external radius, and R be the inner radius of this cylinder. Okay, so these two things we have taken. Now what is given? See the difference between outside and inside surface area. The difference between outside and inside surface area. For surface area, we use which formula? 2 pi RH. Okay? So, according to the given thing, we will take that 2 pi capital R into H minus 2 pi small r into H. What is the difference given? 44 centimeters square. So, E is equals to 44 centimeters square. Okay? So, according to the given thing, this we have taken 2 pi capital R, because outer radius is capital R, that we have taken, and inner radius is small R, so that we have taken. Okay, so the difference between this is 44 centimeters square. Okay, but here we can take 2 pi and H, which is available in both the terms, that we can take common. So that I am taking now 2 pi in bracket, what is going to become capital R minus small r into H is equal to 44 centimeters square. Okay, value of pi is 22 by 7. Okay, and height is given, that is the length is given 14 meter long. Okay, so that we can put here. So 2 multiplied by 22 by 7 into r minus small r into height is 14 is equal to 44 centimeters. Okay, so here 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 22 twos are 44, and 44 twos are 80. So what is going to be given here? Capital R minus small r is equal to 44 divided by 18. 44 divided by 18. This product is 18. So that product we have to take that set and we will divide. 44 divided by 18. So finally we will answer R minus R is equal to 44. Ones are 44. 44 twos are 18. So 1 by 2. So this is our first equation. Okay. So with the help of given things, we got thickness. Capital R minus small r is the thickness of the hollow cylinder. Okay. Now, one more thing they have given us that we will use now here. Okay. This is half part of the answer. Now, what is given? See, if the pipe is made of 99 cubic centimeter, cubic centimeter means this is the volume of the cylinder. Okay. Made of 99 cubic centimeter. So, here also we need to find out the difference between volumes, outer volume and inner volume. Okay. So, how we can mention that? Pi r square h minus pi small r square h is equal to 19. So, this is our second equation with the help of given. Okay. So, this is half statement. If the pipe is made of 99 cubic centimeter, this is hollow cylinder, so we have to find out the difference between two volumes. Okay. So, it is equal to 19. So, now here also we can take pi and h is common, so we can take that pi in bracket capital R square minus small r square into h is equal to 99. Okay, so now what we can put here, 22 by 7 multiply by height is same 14 into r square minus r square. This is a square minus b square property we can use it. A square minus b square gives us a plus b into a minus b. So that I am taking out here r plus small r, r minus small r is equal to 90. Okay, why we have taken this is because we have r minus r, small r minus, sorry, capital R minus small r is equal to 1 by 2. We have that, we can use it. Okay, so now I am taking this 7 2s are 14, 22 2s are 44, 44 multiplied by r minus r is 1 by 2. So that I am taking here 1 by 2 multiplied by r plus r. Okay, is equal to 99. Okay, so now here 2, 22 2s are 44. Okay, so now r plus capital R plus small r is equal to 99 divided by 20. Okay, so here we can take LHCM 11 2s are 22, 11 9s are 99. So 9 by 2. So this is our second equation. Okay, first we got r minus r, second we got r plus r. Okay, so now we have two equations. So if we will add them, equation 1 and equation 2, we will add them, then we will get values of both the radians. Okay. So now by adding first and second, so that I am taking here r minus r, these LHS plus LHS of the second equation, r plus r is equal to 1 by 2 RHS plus this RHS 9 by 2. Okay, so now here these two r we can cancel. So what is remaining here? R plus r, 2r. So 2R is equal to here denominators are same, so 9 plus 1 10, 10 by 2 is 5. Okay, 9 plus 1 10, 10 by 2 is 5. So now capital R is equal to 5 divided by 2, so that is 2.5. So we got here radius 2.5 centimeters. Okay, so this is radius 2.5 centimeters. Understood? Now here we have to find out second radius. So we will put this value in equation first or second. Okay, so second equation I am taking now here, r plus r is equal to 9 by 2. This is second equation, r plus r is equal to 9 by 2. So this r value we will put here, 2.5 plus r is equal to 9 by 2. So r equals to 9 by 2 minus 2.5. R equals to 9 by 2 minus 2.5. So R equals to small r is equals to 9 minus 2.5 to the 5 divided by 2. So 9 minus 5 is 4. 4 by 2 is 2 centimeters. So here finally we got both the radius. Capital is outer radius is 2.5 and inner radius is 2 centimeters. Okay. So this was the flow of answer. What was given thing? The difference was given. With the help of difference, we have to find out R minus R, that is the thickness. Then with the help of this second statement, we have to find out this R plus R. Okay, finally we will add them, then you will get capital R and small r. So this is the inner radius and this is the outer radius. Our second problem is a well with 10 meter inside diameter is dug 14 meter deep. Earth taken out of it is spread all around to a width of 5 meter to form an embankment. Find the height of the embankment. We have to find out height of the embankment. Okay. So first you will try to prepare your figures, then you will get the idea. See what is given, a well with 10 meter inside diameter. Okay. A well with 10 meter inside diameter. Diameter is 10 meter. Okay. So obviously its radius will be 5 meters. Okay. But take a well with 10 meter inside diameter is the 40 meter deep. Okay. So what is given here? Height is given. Height is given 40 meter. Okay. Height 40 meter. Then earth taken out of it is, whatever earth is taken out from this, taken out of it is spread all around to a width of 5 meter. Okay. Whatever earth is taken, that is spread all around in 5 meter deep. 5 meter deep. Okay, so there is one embankment is formed. This is embankment, this area. Okay, so spread all around to a width of 5 meter to form an embankment. Find the 10 meters. So its radius will be 5 meters. Okay, inner radius will be 5 meters. And this width is 5 meters. Width is 5 meters. So we can understand the outer radius. Outer radius will be R. That is equals to R. R is 10 meters. Okay. So capital R, which is outer external radius, is 10 meters, and inner radius is 5 meters. So two things we have now. So here I am taking that R is equals to 10 meter and small r is equals to 5 meter. Okay, that is inner radius and outer radius. Okay, these two things we have. Now we have to find out the height of this embankment. Okay, so to find out height of this embankment, what we can do here, first we have to find out volume of earth dugout. Whatever earth is taken from this. Okay, from this radius 5 meter, the circle which is having radius 5 meter. Okay, we have to find out volume of earth dugout. Earth dugout is equals to means volume of cylinder here we have to use, that is pi r square h. Okay, because inner radius, so small r we use. Okay, so now here pi equals to 22 by 7, radius is inner radius is 5 meter multiplied by 5 meter into height is, what is the height we have told us? 14 meters. So here I am taking 14 meters. Okay. So 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14. So what is doing? What is reading here? 22 5s are 110, 110 into 5 twos are 10. So here it will be 1100 meter cube or cubic meter. Okay. So this is the volume of earth dugout. Okay. Now, second thing we have to find out area of this embankment. Okay, area of this embankment. Area of embankment. How to find out area of embankment? There are two circles. We have to find out area of the shaded line. So, what we can do? Area of outer circle minus area of inner circle. That will be the area of embankment. Okay, so that I am doing here area of outer circle. Area of outer circle is this whole area. From this inner circle area we will subtract and we will get area of this, okay, minus area of inner circle. So area of outer circle is equals to, how to find out area of outer circle? Area of circle is pi r square, only radius is capital R. So here we will get pi r square minus area of inner circle will be pi small r square. Okay, so now here we can take pi, we can take common, so what is going to remain? Capital R square minus small r square. Okay, so now here 22 by 7 multiplied by r square means r, what is the outer radius? 10 meter. This 5 plus 5. Okay, so 10 square minus inner radius is 5, so 5 square, so equals to 22 by 7 multiplied by 10 square is 100 minus 5 square is 25, so 100 minus 25 will be 75. Okay, 75 meter square. This is area, so meter square meter. Okay, now two things we have. We have volume of earth around and we have area of embankment, which is 22 by 7 into 75. You can solve further also. Okay, but now question is we have to find out height of the embankment. Okay, so height of the embankment, to find out height of the embankment, what we have to do? We have to divide this volume of earth dugout, we have to divide by this. Okay, then we will get height of the embankment. Okay, so now I am taking that here. Height is equals to volume of earth, which is dugout, divided by this area of embankment. So, area of embankment. Okay, so volume of earth dugout is, what is that? 1100 meter cube divided by 22 by 7 multiplied by 75. So, 22 upon 7 multiplied by 75 meter square. So, this will be cancelled. Only single unit will remain. So, here we can take 1100. Divided by 22 multiplied by 75, this 7 we will take here. Okay, so here 22, 25, 3 are 75, 25, 4 4s are 100, again 100, 25, again 4, 20, 2 1s are 22, 22 2s are 44. So here what is remaining? 7 2s are 40, 40 divided by 3 meters. So 3 4s are 12, remaining 2, 20, 3 6s are 18, 3 6s are 18. So 4.66 meters is the height of the embankment. Okay. So what was given here? Once again, see, okay, with 10 meter diameter. Diameter is 10 meter, so inner radius will be definitely 5 meter. Okay. 14 meter deep. 14 meter deep means what? Its height. Height is 14 meter. Outer radius is 10 meter according to the given thing. Spread all around to the width of 5 meter. So outer radius is 10 meter, inner radius is 5 meter. So volume formula, first we have to find out volume of per dugout. That formula we have taken, and you will get here. Volume is 1100 meter. Then area of embankment. Area we have to find out. Here this here area of outer surface minus area of inner surface we have to use. So that will be 22 by 7 multiplied by 7. And height we have to find out. So volume, this volume divided by area of embankment.